New information tonight. It turns out Hellgate High released more than just the sensitive student information last December. Good evening, everyone. I'm Steve Fettfein.
And I'm Laurel Staples. We've just learned that data breach also included private information on alumni and deceased students. The district initially said current Hellgate High School students' information had been compromised after an assistant principal included the information in a December email to parents.
Montana McLaughlin has been researching how long Missoula Public Schools keep those sensitive records on file, and she's live now in the newsroom with more.
Steve, the district says the leaked information also mentioned about 200 former students, at least two who have died. It included academic, medical, disciplinary, and criminal information back from 2012. The superintendent was not available for comment today, so I looked into the district policy and found some interesting differences about sensitive student information from the states.
I don't think they'd need to have that.
Emma Webster and Kingsley Nuzo were surprised to learn how long Missoula schools hang on to sensitive information.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, I think that's kind of creepy.
According to the MCPS school board records, the district keeps disciplinary information, psychological reports, and more up to 8 years, and some information permanently.
It might be too long. They could cut it down substantially.
Hellgate Junior Holland Smith is okay with the 8-year mark.
I think 8 years is a reasonable amount of time considering, you left the school, you're gone.
Webster said information like juvenile, criminal, and disciplinary records shouldn't follow students into their adult lives.
If you got in a lot of trouble when you were younger and you were trying to move on from that, and the school had that stuff, it'd be kind of hard.
But here's the problem. No one's sure whether the school or the state makes the decision.
I'm holding a copy of the state's policy on student records and Missoula County's, and they almost directly contradict each other.
The state says health records, some standardized tests, and discipline records should be destroyed after graduation. But the rule seems to leave it up to the districts.
It should be almost as soon as we graduate, it shouldn't be in the school anymore because it's not really the school's responsibility, and quite frankly, things like this do happen every now and then.
There are 11 occasions when student records can be released. That list includes, but is not limited to, court orders, emergencies, any written and signed consent, or for research. So how long do some think public schools should keep personal information?
2 years would be an optimal time.
Maybe for about 2 or 3 years, but that's about it.
If they're given the responsibility of holding students' information like that in the first place, they should try to be a little bit more careful about what they're doing with it.
Now the question, is the state or the district's policy the right one? We also called up to nearly 10 different agencies across the state to see why there was a discrepancy between the state rules and the school boards, but no one was able to confirm that. We will hopefully be speaking with the superintendent tomorrow to find out more information. Live in the newsroom, Montana McLaughlin for NBC Montana.
The Hellgate administrator responsible for the data leak resigned in December.